You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, and it's time for Don't Judge on your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM.
Yikes. Today's Don't Judge. What did you do as a kid that got you into some serious big trouble? Let us know on the HOM app, on Facebook, or give us a call at 800-228-1949. It's all being brought to you by A-Best Window, the only main company that manufactures and installs their own main-made windows, proudly, by the way. So thanks to the gang, I've got some new windows from those guys. So Matthew was like, I was the oldest, so I did not have to do anything to get in trouble because everything I did got me in trouble. Then I got a little brother. My trouble doubled because he did nothing wrong. He did everything wrong. Laura did not give details, but says that she gave her brother a concussion. That'll get you some serious trouble. Oh, Leanne Marie threw rocks at cars, scratched her brother and drew blood. I did that. I didn't throw rocks at cars necessarily, but I was in the back of a pickup truck and there were like pebbles in the back, like gravel. And I would fling them over the edge because they would really fly.
Right.
And there were cars. And
I threw rocks at trains.
What is it with kids and throwing rocks?
I don't know.
It's so weird.
We all did on the street that I grew up on.
Good old Mark threw a baseball through a stained glass window at his father's church. Denied it. Then he showed me the ball with my name written on it. Mark, you lied. At a church. I'm so sorry. It was nice knowing you. Hope says, ran the well dry, left the water running after filling up the livestock tanks, and went to school. Oh. Oh. And she has the emoji of, like, the shoulder shrug.
Right.
What are you going to do?
That's the shoulder shrug. What are you going to do?
That is such a bummer. All right. So what did you do as a kid that got you into some serious trouble? Let us know on Facebook, on the HOM app, or call 800-228-1949. It's Don't Judge.
You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station.
My favorite Christmas station.
94.9 HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM.
On the line with us this morning with a big announcement is New Center Maine's Lee Goldberg. Good morning, Lee.
Good morning, children. How are we doing?
We're doing great. But listen,
yeah,
we've been who cares what's going on with us? We've been on pins and needles.
You ask a valid question.
You have made us wait too long for your big announcement. What is it, Mr. Lee Goldberg from New Center Maine?
Oh, I even get the drum roll. I feel like everybody's going to be disappointed. Because there's not enough going on in our lives, we have decided to start a nonprofit called Prostate Cancer Maine. I want to focus kind of on getting guys tested. A couple years ago, I got diagnosed with prostate cancer, had zero symptoms of any kind, never had a sick day from work in my life. And I just happened to show up on a random blood test that my doctor happened to be doing as part of my annual physical. So it was kind of an, oh, by the way, if it can happen to someone like me, and guys generally don't go to the doctor until something's wrong with them. So we started a nonprofit. My urologist, actually, ironically, his wife and Karen and I are the four board members. And my doctor and his wife and Karen and I have become really close friends in the past couple of years. And sitting around dinner one night talking about how we can advance the cause. And this is what we came up with. So,
well, that's awesome. So it's called Prostate Cancer Maine.
And we have our first event planned.
Oh.
And that I will tell you about next Monday.
What? Oh, you're such a tease. I love it.
I love it. And men's health is something that generally just doesn't get talked about enough.
We want to host your third event.
It's a really easy thing to get your PSA test. It's literally a blood draw.
Good Lord. So, you know what they have to do to us? They have to poke and prod.
I know. and not only is it a blood draw, but if you happen to go to the doctor, you know, for regular physicals, it's the same vial of blood that they already have when they test for your cholesterol and your white blood cells. It's literally the same blood. It's not even extra work for you. It's just an extra test to run the same route.
Jeff, have you had yours done?
I just had blood done like a week ago or something like that, but I didn't know that.
Not every primary care physician will test you for a PSA. If your doctor won't do it, then get a new doctor.
Go ask for it. Give me your doctor's name.
It's right down
no,
the street.
You won't. You'll forget. I got it. I'm on it, Lee.
Thanks, Lori.
I am Jeff.
You don't even have a prostate.
I am Jeff's prostate advocate. You're the only one I like that has a prostate. So. Lee Goldberg, the nonprofit is the Prostate Cancer Maine. We're proud of you and good for you.
Can email at prostatecancermaine@gmail.com.
We support you 100% in this endeavor and good for you for turning something bad into something good.
Thank you, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Lee.
Appreciate it. Bye.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station. HOM. You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff. And now it's time for your daily distractions.
Being brought to you by the Bill Dodge Auto Group. Plenty of inventory on the ground and thousands of five-star reviews. Discover the difference at BillDodgeAutoGroup.com. A woman on TikTok explains that she's dumping her boyfriend because he refuses to get her toilet paper when the bathroom she was using ran out. Like, Elaine, can you...
Spare a square?
Spare a square.
Yeah, except like...
Only you sleep
with
this
person.
Was
this in a public place or was it home?
No, I didn't dive into it enough because all I saw was woman dumps boyfriend for not getting her toilet paper and thought, good enough for me.
And does it on TikTok.
Of course she does it on TikTok.
And of course here we are talking
and
about it.
And of course we are. All right, I don't want to poke the tiger, but 50% of people... say Die Hard is not a Christmas movie.
Mm-hmm.
50%. Mm-hmm. That's why we did The Five Calls Says It All, which did say it was a Christmas movie, because it is such a close one. But others include Gremlins.
Yeah, not a Christmas movie.
Which I don't know if I've ever seen, actually.
I liked it when I was 14, not so much now.
Batman Returns.
No.
Don't remember it at all. And Edward Scissorhands is 100% a Christmas movie. Yeah, I'm sure you haven't seen
that. Seen it, no.
Yeah, great. So you can't.
all the rest I've seen.
You can't. Edward Scissorhands, a Christmas movie. Brenda Lee's Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree, which we just played a couple songs ago. Was hit number one. Just hit number one for the first time since it was released 65 years ago. That is a record.
On which chart?
At 78, the Hot 100.
Are you kidding me?
No, at 78 years old, Brenda is the oldest artist to reach the top Hot 100.
I think we might have had something to do with that.
Of course we had something. That's amazing. I had to read that several times because I thought, obviously, I'm reading this wrong. Maybe it's like, yo, Brenda Lee. Or something like somebody new. No, that song.
Some songs just will stand the test of time.
I guess so. In the Hollywood comedy Family Switch, I have not heard of this or seen it. A brother and sister trade bodies with their parents. Family Switch.
Parent trap? Is that what that is?
No, brother and sister. The parent trap is like a daughter and a mother.
Okay.
But this is the whole family switch is a brother and sister switch with mom and dad.
Okay.
So in the movie, it's a movie. Mm-hmm. It's a made-up movie. The brother and sister, who have now become mom and dad, kiss. And it really bothered some viewers who compared it to incest. Because it's a movie. Did I mention it was a movie?
I think you mentioned it's a movie.
It's a made-up thing?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can't really do that?
Right. Probably they're actually both the actors same age. the actors and actresses.
Oh, God. Millie Bobby Brown, 11.
Yep.
Loves Christmas so much, she puts her decorations up before Halloween.
Oof.
Now... I didn't know this, or I missed this flash of news, but 11 is engaged.
Yeah, she's...
Okay, but she's 11.
No, that's not her age.
Did I say her age? She says her fiancé is against it, but she doesn't care because that's where she thrives. And he can suck it. So Millie Bobby Brown puts up her Christmas tree before Halloween. Mm-hmm. And let's see here. Let's see if I have any more disturbing news like that. Oh, you're going to love this. There's a term called the Golden Retriever Man. This will be my last one. That's a guy who's like the breed of a dog. Sweet, gentle, affectionate, and eager to please. And most importantly, easy to train.
That is not me.
So if you see somebody going out to dinner with a man and she's got a rolled up newspaper, he's a golden retriever man.
You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff. Maine and New Hampshire's official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM.
Good morning. It's Tuesday, December 5th, 7-Eleven. Hey, if you want in on this holiday gift of convenience with the Big Apple stores in 94.9 HOM, just grab the 94.9 HOM app because you could win a $100 gift card to Big Apple stores. 73 yeah. locations all across Maine and New Hampshire. So there's got to be one somewhere near you.
There's like 8 near me.
again, just grab the 94.9 HOM app and we're going to keep announcing winners every day, every weekday, right through December 22nd.
So last night, John Tesh came to Aura.
What a show.
What a show. And I'm so sorry if you missed it. We'll have to do that again at some point. But it was like everything came together. He's about to go on a 13-stop tour. He's in Connecticut to start that tour. So I didn't realize. I thought we were in the middle of his tour, like, and he did a detour of the tour.
We were like the practice.
Yeah. We were the appetizer for his tour. So he came here. He didn't, he didn't charge us anything. He didn't even make us get his hotel or fly him out here. He took care of everything. And so when he got here, a lot of people had asked, hey, is the John Tesh concert still happening with the weather? It is. Because he came straight from L.A. So, this is fantastic. So as I'm going over to Aura to set up and do some decorations, we see some guy trying to get into Aura. It's John Tesh. He's like an hour early, right? And I'm like, oh my God.
Yeah. Man.
And he's like, and I thought, is that big, very tall man John Tesh? And yeah, it was. So we get him in, we get him set up. He was so nice. I mean, I spent hours with John Tesh yesterday. Hours. A good 5 hours I hung with John and his stepson, Gib, who I kept wanting to call Gil.
That's his dad.
Because Gil Gerard is his father.
Right.
But Gib Gerard is his name. So anyway, and then when the concert finally happened at 6 o'clock, it was just spectacular. Yeah. Now, I'd been through all the sound checks, so I kind of got a little sneak peek of it, and I knew it was going to be.
Yeah, you kept saying, this is going to be amazing, guys. You won't believe what I saw. This is going to be amazing. It's like, calm down, Lori.
And then, it's so funny. Before he took to the stage, he wanted to talk to the sound guy. And Aura was just the perfect venue for this. I'm so, so, so grateful to those guys to make it happen. And Joshua and Nick last night were
so great.
It really was a perfect night. And yes, I've been asked this 1,000 times. John Tesh is just as nice in person. He really, truly is.
Super nice.
It's not like, you know, I even tried to sneak and hear something like, you know, oh, he's got to go off on somebody sometime, right? He's got to have the evil part of him that, you know, shows up behind.
I don't think he's got one.
He's just super nice. And then, talk about strange 6 degrees of separation, small world.
Oh, my God. Okay.
So John has a couple of guests, he tells me, that are coming to be with him backstage and, you know, hang out in the green room and be his guest. And, you know, and we arrange a dinner for them. It's Steve and Catherine. I said, all right, whatever. Whatever you want, John. So Steve and Catherine come and they're like, hi, we're guests of John.
And at that point, they hadn't told me who they were.
Right.
We didn't know who they were. They just knew they were guests of John's.
Yep. And then Catherine turns around.
But I recognize her, this woman.
Right. And I'm like, whatever. You know. She turns around and she says, hi, Jeff. We were classmates. What?
And the crazy part is she is a twin. She's got a twin sister. And they were both in my class. I haven't seen either of them since graduation, I don't think.
Insane.
And I'm looking at her like, Are you Catherine or are you Sarah? Like, hey, I didn't, and obviously then she let me know which one she was, which is weird when you know somebody and you got to think, well, which one are you?
So we started thinking, wait, you went to somebody who went to school who's like best buds with John Tesh, but it's her husband was John Tesh's college roommate.
Yep.
And Steve and Catherine live in Maine now.
Yep.
but they went to school in North Carolina, and he still keeps in touch with Steve, and they're like good buddies, and he gives Steve all the credit for getting him into the radio TV end of things, because what was he doing? An engineer or some kind of technical engineer or something?
I'm not sure what he was doing.
I don't know what he was doing, but who cares what he was doing? It's what he is doing. Anyway.
Catherine said to me, I asked her, what are you doing these days? I'm retired. I'm like, oh, cool.
We're not.
I'm going to die in the studio.
And aren't I the same age as you, Catherine?
No, hey, you can do that. That's awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you to John and Gib and to all the listeners who came out. Oh, it was a packed show. I think the audience had a great time. If you want to learn more about it, I put up a couple of pictures and, of course, a selfie. 94.9 I was like, I did not. I spent 5 hours with you and I don't have a selfie.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff. Your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, 94.9 HOM.
We've got two tickets to go see the magic of Christmas this Friday. It's going to be spectacular. It's a tradition. It's been around for over 30 years, and you could be sitting there this Friday. But you got to do a little work for us. You have to sing the first part of la 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 la, and then have the whoever's around you finish it. We've got Cassie and Willow on the line with us this morning. Good morning, Cassie.
Good morning.
Okay, you, Cassie, mom, and Willow, 7-year-old daughter, are heading to Biddeford Elementary. And are you there yet?
I'm here. I'm in the parking lot. And there's a couple of people. So
see. No, you're going to have to go into, like, where there's more than a couple. Let's get you into a crowd, okay?
Okay, hold on a second.
Okay.
Let's walk. We have to go in. We'll have to come back and get our stuff.
You'll be fine.
All right, let's go. Come on. We'll come back and get our stuff. You're not alive right now.
Sure we are.
Yeah. Yeah, we are on the radio, so don't swear.
No, I'm not swearing.
She's out of school. Why would she be doing that?
My car is waiting to drop kids off right now. Oh. And probably watching me run into the school.
Oh, they'll be fine. Yeah, they'll be okay.
They'll be fine.
They'll say,
it's good old Cassie.
Yeah.
It's crazy Cassie.
They all know, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. It looks like there's about 5 or so people.
That sounds great.
That's enough.
All right, here we go. All right, can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Am I going?
Yes,
do it.
La 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 la.
Oh my God, Cassie, the school nurse at Biddeford Elementary, that was fantastic. Now get back to your car, get your stuff, and hang on because we've got those tickets to the magic of Christmas for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Cassie. Oh, I love this.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff.
I like that it brings me back to my childhood.
Your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff. And it's time for Don't Judge on your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM.
Don't Judge is being brought to you by A-Best Window, the only main company that manufactures and installs their own main-made window. We're talking about the food you can just plow right through. Now, we had lunch with Jim over at A-Best Window this past summer at Ken's Seafood. I can't remember what he ate, but I do know he plowed right through it. So
I can't remember what I ate either, but I plowed right through it.
So I'm just going to go, Jim can plow right through Ken's.
I think it might have been scallops. I don't know.
I don't remember what he ate because it was gone so fast.
Oh, I'm talking about me.
Oh, you? Who knows? God, just keep your fingers away from Jeff.
Wasn't around long enough to see.
So what is it for you? What's the food that you can plow right through? 800-228-1949.
Don't judge. What's the food you can plow right through?
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti? I was thinking of having that for dinner tonight.
I'm telling you, it's the pastas.
Homemade spaghetti is the best.
You don't mean the actual pasta. You just mean the sauce.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I don't know. You could be fancy.
Sure can.
Hey, thanks for calling.
Don't judge. What's that food that you can plow right through?
Definitely the shrimp platter with cocktail sauce. I always eat those right through.
Oh, are you you're the guy that has the giant pile of tails in his cocktail napkin?
That's me too.
And everybody's like, hey, save some shrimp for us. And you're like, yeah. Yeah,
that's literally me.
Thank you.
Yeah, have a good day, you guys.
You too.
Don't judge. What's that food you can plow right through?
Okay, my son is saying cranberry sauce. He ate a whole can by himself.
Oh, God.
Just pop that top and give him a spoon.
He just gets a spoon and dumps it. Okay, done. Why don't do a bowl? My daughter likes my mom's, because I'm from West Virginia, biscuits and gravy.
Oh, my God.
And fried apples. Now, I, being from down south, can make pulled pork and some awesome baked beans.
Holy
so if you
crap.
Guys ever invite me, I will come and bring the pulled pork I do for Peas Garbage.
You're invited.
Okay, I will come. I will bring it. I have two smokers. I'll bring you all a big plate of it.
Gee, God, yes.
Okay. And my baked beans, people say I should patent them.
Well, yeah, because B&M sucks now, so we need something new. What's your name?
Andy.
Andy's beans, yes. It just flows off the
Andy's
tongue.
Andy's pulled pork and beans. Open that store. Open that restaurant.
I will open a smoke shack for y'all.
Oh, my God. We will sponsor you free.
I will bring them to y'all next week. How's that?
Oh, my God. Andy, I'm writing this down, Andy, okay? It's on a sticky.
Actually, I might try to bring it Friday because I'm heading up to that church in Bath, so I'll bring it.
Oh, you're the pastor. Yes, Andy. Yes, on your way through.
Man, what don't you do, Andy?
Bell, F-A-I-L. So a bell dancer, right?
Oh, my God.
First attempt in learning. There you go.
We appreciate the call, Andy. Preacher
All right,
Andy.
Have a great day.
All right, you too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, bye-bye.
Okay, this is having a lovely side effect, this don't judge. What can you plow through that you'd like to share with us? Side note, must be delivered on Friday. We're having a buffet.
Also, side note, sharing not absolutely required.
No, not at all. But
we're not going to say no.
Don't judge is, what is that food you can plow right through? Let us know on Facebook, on the HOM app, or give us a holler at 800-228-1949. Don't judge.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, Maine and New Hampshire's official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM.
Good morning.
Five calls says it all on the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff.
Press that button a little too early.
Yeah, that's quite all right.
Good morning anyway.
It's a button pressing kind of morning. All right, so Five Calls Says It All is kind of inspired by Uncle Nicky because he's such a fan, but I'm pretty sure he's the only one on the planet of fruitcake. Do you like fruitcake? Do you love it or hate it?
No.
I can't stand
it. It's not cake.
I've tried 1,000 times to like fruitcake. My sister likes fruitcake. My sister, who's not like 80.
What's worse than fruitcake are people who give fruitcake as a gift.
I got fruitcake as a gift from my sister.
Yeah, that's
because she's like, you'll love it.
That is on par with Clark Griswold not getting his bonus, but getting a membership to the Jelly of the Month Club.
That's, yes, it is the big, giant Christmas vacation of presents. It's awful. I can't, it's that fake fruit crap that's in it. It's not even fruit.
Right.
It's like.
It's not fruit. It's not cake. It's neither.
So Five Calls will say it all, though. So if you guys love fruitcake, you got to let us know, because I don't think anybody does. 800-228-1949. Five Calls says it all. Love fruitcake. Hate fruitcake.
Well, I'd even take I kind of like fruitcake as a responsible answer. You see what I'm saying?
I mean, I always want to try fruitcake, but I'm always horribly disappointed.
Well, just look at it.
Exactly. It doesn't. And then those maraschino cherries.
I don't think anyone wants to call to admit they like fruitcake.
Nah, they'll call. 800-228-1949.
What are we saying?
Five calls. That's a good question. What are you saying? Five calls. Fruitcake, love it or hate it?
Hate it.
Hate it. There we go. Here comes.
There's two people in the car or one person in the car?
Two people.
Okay. You both hate it?
Both hate it.
It's only counting as one.
Okay.
One vote per carload. Thanks for calling.
Thank you. Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with hate.
I'm going to go with hate.
Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it? No. Okay. Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it?
What's the matter with our phones?
I don't know what's the matter with our phones. Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it?
A big no for me.
Big no. Okay. It could be a clean sweep, but we can get out of this hell.
That we chose to get in ourselves.
That we stepped right in.
Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it?
Love it.
Oh!
And you do not sound 80.
No, I am actually only 40, but it's because of my dad. And unfortunately, this will be my second Christmas without him. But he would literally cry if he did not get fruitcake for Christmas. And I actually tried it, and it's really not that bad, especially if you like raisins.
Well, in honor of your father, I think that's a great tradition, and I'm glad that you can stomach it because... I'm so sorry you lost your dad, and I'm so sorry he loved fruitcake. So.
I am too, but I mean, that's who he was. It was fruitcake, mincemeat pie, and liver. So I
mean,
he had a very strong palate.
It's a trifecta of old man food.
That's a plate I don't want to see.
But it made him happy.
That's all that matters. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thanks for calling.
All right, we still on the cusp. Five calls, fruitcake, love it or hate it?
Love it.
What is happening here?
Love it? Really?
Great with eggnog.
Who is this?
This is Gene Paul.
All right, Gene. I'm marking you down.
Gene Paul loves fruitcake.
The fruitcake lover. All right.
Gene, you
have made this a true. Five calls says it all. Thanks, Gene.
Thanks, Gene. All right. Here we go.
Holy cow.
I did not expect this at all.
This could ruin my day.
This could be an upset. Five calls. Fruitcake. Love it or hate it?
There you go.
Woo! That was close.
Saved us.
However, I love cake, but not fruitcake, because I'm pretty.
Oh, man.
Where's Uncle Mickey? We need to do a show.
Yeah, we did. You and Uncle Nicky. I should conference you with Uncle Nicky. You would blow his mind, just to let you know.
Oh, my word. Yes, we would.
Oh, my God.
I would remind him of Overhead Door.
That's White Mountain Overhead Door to you, lady.
Mountain Overhead Door.
Oh my God. You are delightful, and thank you for tipping. The five calls says it all. Fruitcake too. Hate it.
You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station.
My favorite Christmas station.
94.9 HOM. You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, 94.9 HOM.
So we have, this is great. So we have $50 to spend at the Kittery Trading Post, which is a fantastic place to get pretty much every single human on your Christmas list and Hanukkah list done. So $50 will get you a good start there. We're going to play Hallmark Christmas movie, real or fake. Now, yesterday, I said Mystery on Mistletoe Island. I misread my handwriting. So I got called out on somebody who loves Hallmark Christmas movies, and she says, that was Mystery on Mistletoe Lane. First of all, that was a real movie. She was being very nice. She wasn't right. Karen-ing it at all. And so, anyway, I've got them all correct this time. So you tell me.
Can you redo your entire list?
Redid the entire list. 800-228-1949. You got to tell me, is this a real Hallmark Christmas movie or did we make it up?
Hi, HOM. Who's this?
Hi, this is Abigail.
Hello, Abigail. Okay, you just got to get 2 out of 3 of the Hallmark Christmas movies, real or fake.
Oh, man.
And you, okay. No, you got this, girl, okay? I have full okay. full confidence in you. Okay, tell me, is this a Hallmark Christmas movie or did we make it up? Mommy drinks because you cry.
You made that one up.
We did.
Yeah. Even though I'd probably watch it.
Before we move on, in a season, how many of all the Hallmark movies do you think you watch?
He's asking you,
like
not
two,
me.
Two
yeah, yeah.
or three.
How many?
2 or 3, right?
Only 2 or 3. Okay.
Okay. All right. Not bad.
I have 2 little kids.
Oh, you got no. Yeah, you got no time to watch that.
I used to watch more.
Yeah. Yes. I live with someone that watches more.
All right. Is this for the win? Is this a real Hallmark Christmas movie or fake? Under the Christmas Sky.
Real.
It is real!
Woo! Yes!
Woo! Woo! A double feature with Mommy Drinks Because You Cry. Abigail, congrats.
I think that's a book, actually.
It's a book. It's a docuseries. It's all sorts of stuff. Abigail, congratulations. You've got $50 to shop at the Kittery Trading Post.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station. HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, 94.9 HOM.
Wow. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody who made the John Tesh show last night at Aura.
Man,
so great.
It was amazing.
It really was.
He is a funny dude. I knew he was because we've talked to him a couple times, but...
In person, he's
just as funny.
And yes, it is confirmed that he is just as nice in person. And what was really sweet is, the audience was just so into it. That was the fun part about it is that we packed the audience with fans. It was a free ticket to get in. It was a sold out crowd and we didn't want to make it like a big giant cross insurance arena thing. It was over at Aura, which was the absolute.
He loved the venue.
Perfect venue for this. Well, it's got everything. I mean, it's like this, it's a really cool venue because trust me, I've seen every floor of it now.
The best part of it, though, is through the whole show, we get to the end and we're doing a question and answer session and they turn on the lights and all of a sudden John realizes there's a third balcony.
Yeah, there's like people everywhere.
Oh, there's people up there. I'm so sorry. I wasn't even playing to you.
So you and I, at the end of the show, went around to the audience for anybody who had a question for John because he was taking some questions. And prior to that, there was a group to the... right of the stage, up close, about 4 women, and they were like, "Oh yeah. I just want John to look longing and loving me into my eyes, right?" So, I of course told John on stage, right. This group over here wants you to look longingly and lovingly into their eyes. So Devin put on the Facebook post that I had up. Thanks for getting him to stare longingly my way. he was very amenable to any request. Wow. So thanks again to Aura and to Joshua and yep. Nick and everybody here that made this happen. And to John and Gib, who just really put on a great, fun, casual, sweet, very good show last night.
And one of the reasons that he did this for us is because we were one of the very first stations to carry his Intelligence Free Life show.
Which he mentioned last night. I mean, he did a whole soliloquy on how great HOM is. And I'm like, don't forget to mention Lori and Jeff. We've just tagged on to this legend 6 months ago.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff.
I like that it brings me back to my childhood.
You're a official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, 94.9 HOM.
Hey, a little more on Tesh last night. Unfortunately, my girlfriend, Michelle, who has been looking forward to that show for months, as soon as we moved
to HOM, she's like, can I meet John Tesh?
Right, yeah. She wasn't able to go for reasons. And so the whole night, I'm like, I'm thinking to myself as I'm sitting in the audience, can I take pictures? Can I do video? Can I record? I don't know. I can't ask John right now.
You missed your opportunity to ask him prior.
I didn't think of it until I sat down. Right. But I did get some pictures and I got some video. And I kept sending it to her. And she would send the sad emoji. She would, and everything. I'm like, I felt so bad because she couldn't be there for this. At least she got a little something.
Yeah, she got it through you.
Got it through me. And I was like, okay, this has got to win me something.
It's got to win you something. I'm surprised you didn't like. Although, okay, all right. Truth be told, because he's off to Connecticut too, on his tour.
Yeah.
Jeff and I, when he left, we went to his dressing room, the little green room, which is, by the way, you walk in and you're like, my God, this place is amazing. It's really.
Yeah.
Their green rooms are fantastic.
Not
right?
Green though.
No, kind of gray. and I said, look at this place. And I was looking for the good food, but John Tesh is so healthy. It was like bananas, apples, and apple juice in the fridge. I was like, wow, super disappointed.
This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, Maine and New Hampshire's official Christmas music station, 94.9 HOM. This is the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff, 94.9 HOM.
What did we learn today, Lori Vornis?
We learned in Five Calls Says It All that people hate fruitcake. It has been confirmed. We also learned that Stephen thinks that he can get us to like fruitcake with his boozy fruitcake. No. He's going to make little mini ones.
Yeah.
He's going to drop them off. It's like a chocolate fruit cake with real fruit and booze. I mean, got to be honest with you. I think I could be converted. We also learned that Boozy Fruitcake is my stripper name.
You chose it.
Because it makes me giggle.
And yet have not stripped, and let's keep it that way.
We learned that people can have very specific foods that they can plow through. That was the Don't Judge today. And
wow,
we could do a whole week of this because people love to talk about the foods they have no control around. and we also learned that one of the best things we're doing this week, at least for Jeff and I, is the drive-through caroling, where we make you go someplace public and sing the first part of fa-la-la-la-la and see if they'll finish it. It's 4 Magic of Christmas tickets, which is an amazing prize, a pair of tickets. So we'll do that again tomorrow.
Okay.
Whether you're driving through, you know, Dunkin' or getting something for breakfast through a drive-through, or you're at a public, you know, you get out of your car and go to a Big Apple, you know, just as long as there's human beings around you that can finish the fa-la-la-la-la. La-la-la-la.
I know one person that could do it. Oh, he's gone. John Tesh.
Oh, yeah.
Would have been the best. We should have done that.
I'll call.
You're listening to the HOM Morning Show with Lori and Jeff on your official Christmas music station.
My favorite Christmas station.
94.9 HOM.